I'm sorry. This had to be done. I'm really sorry. But neither of us can help it. Why didn't you go out? You joined the dancers. Go out and dance. If you really don't hate me for this separation, go out and dance. One of the men will see you dance. He will like your dancing. He will marry you. Who knows but that? With him, you will be luckier than you were with me.
I don't want any man. I don't want any other man.
You know very well that I won't want any other woman either. You know that, don't you? Lumna, you know it, don't you?
Yes, I know.
It's not my fault. You cannot blame me. I have been a good husband to you.
Neither can you blame me.
No. You've been very good to me. You've been a good wife. I have nothing to say against you.
You know that I have done my best. I have prayed for communion. You remember? You were from your work. And you were angry. Because I pastured all your pigs. I did it to appease communion. Like you, I wanted to have a child. But what could I do?
Communion does not see fit for us to have a child. I came home because I needn't find you among the dancers. Of course, I'm not forcing you to come. If you don't want to join my wedding ceremony, I came to tell you that Madulina, although I am marrying her, can never become as good as you are. You are one of the best wives in the whole village.
That has not done me any good, has it?
This house is yours. Make it your own. Live in it as long as you wish.
I have no need for a house. I'll go to my own house. My parents are old. They need me.
I'll give you the field that I dug out in the mountains during the first year of our marriage. You know I did it for you.
I have noise for a field. Go back to the dance. They will look for you. Madulima, you will not feel good. Just go back to the dance.
It would be better if you could come. Dance for the last time. The dancers are playing.
You know that I cannot.
I did this because of my need for a child. The men have mocked me behind my back. You know that.
I know it. I will pray that Kabunyan bless you and Madulima. Awiyaw, I'm useless. I must die.
It will not be right to die.
I don't care about the fields. I don't care about the house. I don't care anything but you.
Then you'll always be fruitless.
Go back to my father. I'll die.
Then you hate me. If you die, it means you hate me. Don't want me to have a child. Don't want my name to live in our tribe. I didn't try a second time. It means I'll die. Nobody will come after me.
If you fail the second time. No, I don't want you to fail.
I fail. Both of us will die together. both of us will vanish from our tribe.
Awiyaw, Awiyaw, they're looking for you at the dance.
I'm not in hurry.
There's room. You better go.
Not until you tell me it is all right.
It's all right.
Do this for the sake of our tribe.
To a guy named Awiyaw. I became his wife, serving him every day, doing all the things that can make him happy, and I could feel the same way from him. We loved each other so much. For years, we thought we're happy, until fate had decided that it had been kind enough. I can't give him what the people around us thought Awiyaw needed the most. I can't bear a child who was supposed to follow his name. And now, he's marrying someone else. It's so sad and heartbreaking for me, but no matter how hard it would be, I have to live my life the way it was before I met my one great love.
Now here it comes, the hardest part of unchain my heart that's holding on. How do I start to live my life alone? Guess I'm just learning the art of letting go. Try to say it's over.